Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
It's the holiday season. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Maria Sorreo, joined by Liz Brown Swanson, and we are here at beautiful Trump National, joined by General Manager Lily Amini and our chef Jean-Pierre Vincent. Now we are here, we're getting ready to eat something wonderful and drink something wonderful from Chef, and we are talking holiday season. And Lily, no better place to come here but Trump, because you have so much going on. Tell us about that.
There really isn't a better place
to be. We love it.
As you can see, the lobby is always festive during this time of the year, and people love it. I can't tell you how many times people stop by and take pictures in front of the tree. It's an amazing, amazing feeling, great ambiance, and we're just really, really happy that this time of the year has come through.
Happy holidays. You really do get into the feel of the season here. Mm-hmm. This tree is magnificent. I don't know how tall it is. You said your dad brought this in.
Yes, 72. I think it's been crazy. It's been crazy. But I think it's like 17 feet.
Wow.
But we really, really enjoy it. We have to have the biggest and most beautiful tree here in the lobby, obviously. But it's decorated so beautifully. And again, it's a highlight and focal point of the holiday season for us here.
I think it gets you into the holiday spirit, it too, does. To see the decorations and the tree. And speaking of spirits, over here, Chef, what are you creating?
I am creating right now the eggnog martini, which we will feature in our holiday cocktails menu for the winter time, as well as I will be doing a figs flambé dessert, is with a coconut ice cream.
I don't know why we don't have eggnog more often, but it's such a fun thing you look forward to at the holidays.
Absolutely, yeah. It's going to be nice and festive with lots of red and green.
Very nice. Okay, we're gonna let Chef work here. And Lily, we're talking about shopping as well, because this is such an amazing place to come to shop. Tell us about that.
Yes, we have one-of-a-kind items, obviously, in our pro shop. We have some great stemware, some great outerwear, great counter items that you guys all should come by. Golfer or not golfer, does not matter. We have some amazing apparel items. And it's a great idea to also get a gift card for anybody in your life that loves coming to Trump for golf, for dining, for anything. And that's really a top seller for us as well.
Of course, I always say one of my favorite gifts that I give so many people that come to visit as a token to remember the community is the stemware here.
Beautiful.
It's absolutely beautiful, and of course, maybe we'll have some of that stemware with our fun holiday cocktail coming up
soon.
Right. But, you know, you do things here all year round. You're open every day of the year. Just talk about some of the exciting things happening here.
Absolutely. Well, coming up December 20th is going to be our holiday brunch, so Santa will be making a visit.
Love that.
He is fantastic, and we cannot wait for that day because it just brings so much joy and spirit to our lobby and our entire property. So we're very, very excited to have that happen. But again, throughout the entire year, we have so many things going on. Our theme nights, our award-winning brunches are just amazing. Dinner menu, happy hour, lunch and breakfast. It's unparalleled. It's beautiful.
And not everybody likes to cook at the holidays. They like
That's
to
right.
come somewhere and
That's
enjoy
right.
a meal.
Yep.
And they can do that here. Talk about what you're going to be having this month.
Definitely. Again, it's our holiday brunch coming up on the 20th. But we are also open Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. So for those who do not want to work in the kitchen those days, please come over. It's going to be a spectacular day, and it's just a beautiful day here at Trump National.
And also New Year's Eve. You have a fun night here, and you pack the ballroom.
We do, and it's going to be an amazing, amazing time. We have a champagne dinner. Please come out and check that menu. It's one thing that we really, really pride ourselves on. It's a great day of the year where you're going to spend a little bit more, but you're going to get what you pay for, and Chef Jean-Pierre is just a master at that and putting some crazy cool things together for that champagne dinner.
Well, and Chef, how do you create everything special that you do for the holidays? How far in advance do you plan this?
We plan definitely a few months in advance to make sure that we're properly ready and, you know, have everything festive and nice for the holidays.
Well, I know, and some of the special foods, some of the special desserts that you make, I mean, everything that he makes is, of course,
is.
Amazing, but it's just so fun to get the figs and the things like eggnog, and what other kind of things do you make special for the holidays?
For the holidays, well, I definitely put a lot of effort into our big brunches, also our theme nights, a lot of thought goes into them, and a lot of passion for the food.
Well, I mean, this man right here has got so much passion when he cooks.
He does, yeah.
And there's no calories here over the holidays.
No. That's
everything
out.
Is calorie free.
Yes.
It's fantastic. That's another thing we pride ourselves on. We take all the calories out of everything.
And, we love that.
Yeah, it makes it extra special.
All right, well, I think that we should actually, we're about to try some of the wonderful things. Look at how the glass is festive in the red and the green colors.
That's right, absolutely.
I'm looking at this cocktail with a candy cane.
Yes, I know.
We might want to reconsider leaving Santa a cookie on the plate.
Or maybe
we might need
Santa
a drink like that.
Like this. Oh my god. gosh, beautiful.
All right. So well, you can have three
we
straws.
We have in here a little bit of creme de menthe. We have some eggnog. Okay. We have fresh vanilla, all right. A little bit of simple syrup, and some fresh ground nutmeg and cinnamon.
Very nice. All right. Well, we are going to taste it. I think we're going to do a little taste.
Yeah, we're all gonna do a little
chef is putting, yes, chef's putting it in the little.
I was thinking we were going to get three straws.
All right. This so is, here, Liz, I'm going to pass it down. Yes.
We have to toast
beautiful.
The holiday.
Beautiful. Absolutely. Well, it's just fun to be festive.
Do you all have any right. holiday traditions you enjoy?
All right, Lily.
Well, we always get the Charlie Brown Christmas tree at our house.
Love that.
We like the rejected trees. Yeah, we have to do that. And just being with family is really the most important thing. Right. Checking in on work to make sure everything's
Chef.
Going well
are
here.
Are you
but
be
being around
with
family,
us?
100% the most important thing.
Great. Absolutely. It's about family.
All right,
family.
So we are all cheering.
Here
and
we
Chef
go.
Chef gets the big one because he made it. So we'll let him have that
health
one.
Health and happiness and continued success here at Trump.
Yes. Cheers.
All right, here we go.
Happy holidays.
I love the mint
delicious.
With the eggnog. I've never done that
I love
combination.
The sugar. All right. Well, when we come back, Liz and I are going to go shopping. And then a little later, Mark J. Dottie is going to go Christmas tree shopping for us. So a lot more coming up. And we will end at the Terranea Resort. So Lily, Chef, thank you so much for having
my
us.
Pleasure.
Don't
enjoy.
Go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring. Snowing and blowing.
All right, this is where it gets exciting. We are ready to begin our holiday shopping.
We're ready to shop, Liz, and we are in a great location right here in RPV. Tell us about it.
All right now we are standing at the Wayfarers Chapel's Visitor Center. It's a great spot to stop off when you come to the famous chapel here. You can come inside here and beautiful, beautiful gifts to shop and learn about the Swedenborgian Church, but we're here to shop.
Well, we're here to shop and to learn a little bit more about the chapel as well. So, Liz, we found some great finds for under $10, so let's go shop.
We have a lot of great gift ideas. We have some jewelry, we have angel figurines, we have little angels to go, which are very popular. We have a lot of little items here that we keep up at the front counter.
This is really the first point where visitors come onto the grounds and they're gonna get a sense of what this place is about, a little bit of the history, a little bit more information about who Emanuel Swedenborg is, and that we are actually a religious tradition, a church and denomination. It's really an educational tool here, as well as a great place to get some nice gifts and books.
We have a lot of local artists. We have some angel chakras and angel crystals here that are made by local artists.
Wayfarers Chapel, the role that it serves right here in RPV, you know, everybody calls us the jewel of the community.
It's built into the name. It's for all wayfarers traveling through life. And then, of course, you got some great architecture and Lloyd Wright. And then it's really become more so the tree chapel, even though it's known more as the glass chapel. As time has continued, the trees continue to grow taller, and it actually lives out into the vision of Lloyd Wright, which is more of a sacred place, I think, that really resonates with a lot of people, not only the location, the views, but also the openness to come and pray and meditate and get a better sense of something beyond themselves.
And of course, back to the holiday season, the magic of the holiday. There's nothing more magical than being in that chapel. Talk about just sort of that, what happens at the holidays.
We have, our Sunday services, and we light a candle each week for that, which is unique in that we have a wreath that's raised every week. We do have Christmas concerts with our chapel musicians. That's going to be on the 20th. And then, of course, everyone looks forward to the Christmas Eve services here. 7:30, 9:30, and 11:30 Christmas Eve.
And for you, what do you like working about in the visitor center?
I love all the people and interacting with the visitors.
All right, Liz. Well, we have shopped until we dropped here in the chapel and found so many really cool things for under $10. I found this angel that lights up. That's a Christmas ornament, but you know, you could put this anywhere. My mom loves angels. So you could really just put this on the countertop and turn the light switch on here. And it's just so pretty. I mean, it's just like a beautiful little angel, and I loved it.
And I found this really fun, sparkly stretch bracelet.
I love
so
that.
Many cool different ones with sparkly jewels, and yes, under $10. So how about that? That's a really fun get. And didn't you have one more thing?
I found the angel wing, which is a keychain. I'm going to turn it around so Mark can see it. And it's just a wing of an angel. So you can take the angel's wing, the guardian angel's wing with you wherever you go.
We all need angels with us.
We do, all the time. So I love that.
And I have one right here. We won't forget her because
oh.
She's a little loud and crazy.
She rings.
Look at We need this to call our guests to dinner at the holidays or to ring in the new year.
That's great.
With that, we're going to wrap it up here at the chapel.
I love it.
All right. It was fun.
It was fun. Let's go keep shopping.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
I'm here with Matthew at the Beacon House here in San Pedro. And to start off with, we're actually at the Christmas tree lot here, but we'll get to that in one sec. Tell me, what is the Beacon House?
The Beacon House is a treatment center for men. We take men off the streets, and we do things like the tree lot to so the men can come in here without anything and get the help they need to be successful.
And what do you consider success after the Beacon House?
Success is leaving, hopefully employed. Myself, I'm in my fourth semester of college, so a lot of the guys graduate, go to school, reintegrate with their families, and leave either working or going to school.
So walk me through, if this is my first time coming through, and I'm like, okay, well, I'll go by the Beacon House, and you know, maybe I'll bring some twine, or I'll bring some gloves. Like, walk me through what you guys do to help get that tree home to us.
If you guys show up, we'll mount it to the roof of your car. We do deliver trees locally for free. And yeah, you just pick the tree you want and we'll take care of the rest.
You'll tie it up for us, put it on the top of our car or in our trunk or whatever?
Absolutely. If the person buying it wants that, we'll do that, or we can deliver it. Either way. We make wreaths out of tree trimmings, and that started 3 years ago when I was new to the house, and they kind of gave me something to do to occupy my time during the holiday season. And now we got a press, and as long as the lot's open, we make 10 and 14 inch Christmas wreaths. All the proceeds go back into the house so that the next guy who needs help can come in without anything. All the jobs we do, community service, all goes directly into the house. You could call 310-514-4940, that's our office, or go to thebeaconhouse.org.
Or you can just swing by here to the Beacon House. What's your address right here?
1003 South Beacon. We got free popcorn and coffee.
Hey, there you go. Come on by for the free popcorn and coffee. Get yourself a treat. They'll take care of getting it on top of your car or deliver it to your house.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much, Matthew.
Thank you.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
Well, we're here at stop number two on our shopping journey, Liz. We're at the Point Vicente Interpretive Center, and the gift shop here is like no other. Really unique, cool things that we are going to shop for today.
The PVIC gift shop is absolutely splendid. Mm-hmm. You find gifts here all year round, but at the holiday time, what I think of coming here is ornaments. I've never seen such a cool ornament selection, and especially because they do a lot of peninsula-themed presents here.
Exactly. Things you won't find anywhere else will be very unique, and all your people that you're giving gifts to, they're going to love it for sure.
And now we're going to do our $10, under $10 challenge, right? Should we get going on that?
Under $10 challenge, we're going to go shopping, and we'll show you what's going on here at the PVIC.
So we order a lot of fun ornaments, as you can see behind me. We have a great selections, ones that are good for kids, ones that are really inexpensive, and like if you just need an easy gift, maybe to put on top of a present, and that'd be a good little accent to that gift that you're giving to somebody. Some of my favorite things, right now we have some great wind chimes in that feature like different animals in the area. They're really fun and pretty for either inside the house or even in your backyard if you have a place to hang it. We have really great stocking stuffers for kids, so like fun little toys that are under $5 that you can get just to fill and put some good things for there. People really love our books because when they're coming here, it's a very educational place, and so they're finding things that will tie directly into this area. Right now we have a new book by one of our docents, Joe Koch. It's The Fossils of Palos Verdes, and it goes over some fossils that you can find in San Pedro and in the peninsula, so that's very unique and it's been a great seller. So coming up, actually, one of the big things here that goes on is the gray whale watching and the migration. The census takers, the American Cetacean Society Los Angeles chapter, will be starting December 1st doing the gray whale count, then migrating down to, they migrate down to Baja and then back north towards February, March, April, those months. But if you come inside and take a look in the museum, we talk about the marine life, the tide pools in the area, which is at Abalone Cove. We talk about the kelp forest, and then the museum kind of goes through the geology and the history of the Palos Verdes Peninsula. So it's really a special experience.
Well, Liz, we didn't have any trouble at all finding amazing ornaments. I went with the sea star, and it's not a starfish, it's a sea star. I learned something today.
And I went with the magnificent sparkly, whimsical peacock feather. I think I saw a dozen types of different peacock ornaments
and
in here.
And beautiful, really, really beautiful and unique. Anybody would love to receive this and hang it on their tree, or you could decorate your house. Just
right.
A lot of really cool things.
And I actually would like to take ornaments if I'm going to someone's house house, and if I'm bringing sparkling cider or wine, you just hang it on the bottle.
That's such
a
nice idea.
Gift.
And then, of course, and these are under $10, too. And then I love these, the little snow globes. And this has snow in it because it's the holidays and we don't see snow, so it's always fun to bring that as a little gift. I love that. That's kind of a fun one.
You gotta have snow over the holidays. And
yes.
Also,
well, you're used to snow, Liz. You come from the East Coast,
right?
So. Yes.
And, of course, one thing, they have so many cool things for children here, and you can't leave the PVIC without a whale.
Of course
and
not.
And, again, under $10, cute stocking stuffer, and you know what? We have a whale of a time every time we come here.
A whale of a time. All right, well, let's move on, and don't forget, though, come to the PVIC, and you will get unique gift ideas that you won't find anywhere else.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
Today we're hosting our 10th Holiday Light Exchange, and that's where we invite all the residents of the South Bay to come and exchange one strand of their old energy guzzling incandescent lights for a box of the new LED holiday lights. There's 100 lights on a strand of 33 feet long, and they use a lot less energy. And you might ask, how much less? Well, it's about 80% you're going to save over what you've been paying to have those incandescent lights up around the holiday season. Well, if they plug them in and they produce heat, it's the old kind. Incandescent lights, that's why they use so much energy, is because they're operating on heat. And so the LED lights, I'll show you right here an example. I can touch these. Cool to the touch. And they've been plugged in for hours. And we've been around, believe it or not, for about 13 years now. And we're happy to say in this location here in Torrance, we're on Western Avenue, and we're open 5 days a week, 9 to 5. So if you do have questions about saving water or energy or better transportation, you can come on by and see us. Well, you can go to our website, sbesc.com. Or you can call us at area code 310-371-7222. And we'll be happy to answer your questions about how do I get a rain barrel or how do I get enrolled in that free class about saving water. We can let you know.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
All right, so our shopping journey continues, and we have landed at one of the most beautiful places you can be on the peninsula. We're at the South Coast Botanic Garden, and we're in the beautiful gift shop.
In the gift shop. Now, the grounds here are lovely. It's so relaxing to walk around. And then you can just pop into this amazing gift shop and find some of the most unique items, fun things for kids, and for us, too,
and
the kids.
What I love about here is you'll find a lot of nature-inspired gifts, of course, because we are at the South Coast Botanic Garden. Mm-hmm. And one of the gifts here is the gift that keeps giving, because plants, it's a great place to come
great
and get
gift.
Plants. Many things we want to check out, and of course we're going to continue our treasure hunt for a $10 or under gift.
And we've been shopping and we found quite a few things here, so Liz, let's show everybody what we found.
There is something for everybody here. I say you got to come and shop here. To see it is to believe it. We have great gifts for mom. We have great jewelry. We have these awesome purses. We have great stationery. We have awesome children's items. I would say anything for your garden. We are a garden, so we do definitely want to make sure that you can decorate your garden as well as plants. We also offer Christmas items, holiday items.
The gift shop is operated by the South Coast Botanic Garden Foundation. It's a great resource in the community to find one-of-a-kind gifts, but more importantly, everything that is sold at the foundation's gift shop actually goes back into helping the garden. We have really great levels of membership. A lot of people like to give them for gifts for the holidays, which is great.
I think it's always a great reminder to let people know we're 87 acres of garden here. And a great resource for the community. So really, I'd like to invite everyone to come down and always make sure to check out our activities on our website, which is southcoastbotanicgarden.org.
All right, because we like lots of flashy little things and under $10, yes it is, it's the little flashy Christmas tree pin, which is always really fun. It's fun to wear to parties. And if you want a really lovely hostess gift, you can put a little candle in this holder. It's really festive, lots of frosty glass here, which is always good. And the greatest coffee mug I've seen in a really long time. Check this out. Looks like a flower pot. It's great for hot cocoa or coffee. Love this.
Yes, that's definitely
so much fun. All under $10.
Hot cocoa in that for sure.
For sure.
Gets you in the mood for the holiday spirit. So some of my gets that I found, great for the gardeners or anybody. We have this wonderful frog. Again, $10 price point. It's so fun to put in the garden all year round.
And then, or in your boot.
Yeah, or in my boot. It's garden wear. And then look at the sleeping gnome. Again, put it on the tree for the holiday or just put it outside in your yard.
Really cute.
Again, these are just so much fun. And then, of course, as you know, I'm the mother of three boys. And as we've been shopping, I've been finding a lot of things for the kids and
sure.
for the moms. But how about something for the dads and the boys in the house? You've got to go home with one of these babies.
That'll brighten up
your
holiday.
It'll remind you to come to the South Coast Botanic Garden all year, and it definitely will brighten the holidays.
Yes, all year long. You can come here, shop, and enjoy the gardens, and have a great time.
And hats off to you, Maria.
Hats off to you, Lizzie.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock.
All right, well, the holiday festivities continue right here at the beautiful Terranea Resort. We're sitting in Sea Beans. Maria, we have Marge Miller, who is the manager of Sea Beans here at Terranea. And over to my right, I have one of Santa's favorite helpers. He's the sweetest guy here. We have the assistant pastry chef, Mark Clear, who's going to make some beautiful ice cream sandwich cookies for the holidays. And so before we get rolling on some of these wonderful cookie delights, we've got Marge here. How is it going over the holidays right now here at Terranea?
Oh, it's exciting. We have a lot of fun things happening. Our tree lighting is coming this Sunday, so we bring a lot of our families from our local neighborhood and tree lighting. We have our shop night here coming up on the 12th of December, so it'll be a little bit of excitement of having, you know, the our local neighbors coming to join us. So. Exciting fun.
And a lot of excitement happening right here in Sea Beans. Since you've become manager, you've really changing things up, and there's a lot of, this is a great place to come shop.
Yes, right. We have a lot of little baskets already made for you, so it's a great thing. The gifts already made, packaged, ready to go. Chef Lee has done some beautiful items of new pastries and new antipastas and bruschettas and lots of things to take home that you can share with your holiday meal.
And we notice it's decorated quite festively as well. It's always fun to see the Christmas tree and the snowmen and everything. Mm-hmm. How long in advance do you plan for that?
Probably about 3 weeks. I try to get my stuff together here within the 3 weeks, and we know December 1st, that's when all of the holiday trimmings go up here at Terranea, so we try to stay, Sea Beans stays in tune with Terranea as far as getting all of our festivities up.
And you know, we always love all of the fun things that we get to eat at the holidays. Now, Mark, is this something special that you make just for the holidays?
This is actually something that we do year round. The difference about the holidays is we start bringing in seasonal flavors. So right here that I brought up today, we do have the traditional chocolate chip cookie. We also have gingerbread cookies. And then this is a nice kind of winter pecan almond cookie.
That sounds good.
As far as flavors go, I brought out our traditional butter pecan because that's great year round, but it does have a little winter and fall influence. And then I brought an eggnog gelato out. All of these are available at Sea Beans right here. And you can order the order sandwiches to order. So, and it's as simple as you let Marge or one of her employees know what you'd like. In this case, I'm going to do eggnog with gingerbread because if I came here at Sea Beans, that's the one I would pick.
I think I would like one of each, Marge.
I would like two. I'm a sweet person.
Me too.
Yeah.
And we keep saying there's no calories in anything.
Yeah,
no calories.
Nothing.
I was
absolutely
told once
not.
The calories don't count if you eat it with your eyes closed.
Yes.
Oh, I love that.
I don't know if that's true or not, but we're going to pretend. We also have tons of festive decorations, different types of sugar, different colors. This one's definitely popular with the kids. Gives a little extra shine, a little extra sheen. And there's always peppermint. What's a holiday without a good peppermint ice cream, right?
It's all about the peppermint eggnog. Bring it on. You've been here working at Terranea since they've opened. You've been here, I think you said, 6 years.
6 years, for sure.
Every time I come in here, I think I see something more beautiful in the dessert case. Talk about the treats that are here all year round.
Well, I would have to say our most famous one is Chef Perry's Caramel Cheesecake Creme Brulee. We definitely take a homemade bocce cookie, crumble it up into a crust. We bake caramel cheesecake on top of that, and then we do a brulee on top of that. Garnish it up, beautiful. We also cater to gluten-free and vegan.
I'm going to be happy to see you roll up that chocolate chip cookie, because you have nothing but the best ingredients here, right, Marge?
Right, exactly. And the chocolate chip cookies Chef Perry has done for the holidays is you get all of the dry ingredients in a jar, all ready to go. You're adding just the wet ingredients. Oh. So you can take home his recipe and make it at home or give it as a gift. So they are jarred here for you to come and pick up if you'd like.
And Marge, also, you're going to tell us about it. We're going to get actually a sneak peek of something that's going on behind closed doors. Tell us about that.
Well, that would be our infamous house, our gingerbread house. But this year, Mark has chosen not to have a house. Mark has a castle.
I was going to say, is it an estate this year?
It is an estate. It's a chateau. Yes, it is our chateau this year.
Do you get the gingerbread chateau?
Yes.
They've been working on this for a while back there.
We've been working on it. I think we're on our third week right now. There's four people diligently working on it. We also have bakers in the back rolling out the dough, cutting out all the pieces. There's definitely Christmas music in the hallway as we decorate, help inspire. Right now, I'd say we're about 90% done. Today, we're going to finish covering it. Tomorrow is all the icing and all the gumdrops and candy canes and gingerbread men. It's about 6 feet tall this year.
Wow.
It's probably about 200 pounds of gingerbread, and I have yet to calculate the man hours, but it's awfully fun.
I think it's always such a special thing when you see a gingerbread house during the holidays. You always want to make one or be a part of it because it's so festive.
Well, this one will take you forever to make, that's for sure. Mark was hoping that little elves would come in the middle of the night and finish it, but it didn't happen.
Well, we already decided you are the sweetest elf here.
Yes.
I definitely try.
You know, one thing I love about coming to the resort all year round is it always feels magical.
It does.
You obviously are decorated for the holidays, but no matter what day of the year it is, just being here and taking in the ocean and the beauty, it's like a place to pause.
Yes, it is definitely a place to pause. And I think, you know, we see year after year, a lot of our families coming back and enjoying traveling from other states to come and stay with us year after year and enjoying that tradition. So it's a wonderful thing.
And for you, what do you love most about the tradition here during the holidays for you at Terranea? I know you said you're working Christmas Day.
I am working Christmas. For me, that is just to see the families enjoying themselves. The tree lighting, I think, for me, is just the kickoff of the holidays, and it just gives you that warm feeling that we've arrived, and here's one more year, you know, our sixth year of a tree lighting. So I'm looking forward to that on Sunday.
Very good. Well, I think we need to taste some of these treats sitting here.
He's got two made, and there's three of us. Are we going to get one more?
Are we going to take a... Oh, he's going to make one more? Boy, Liz wants her own. She's not going to share with any of the rest of us, Marge. So
no,
that,
I know
Mark,
she's
for
not.
For you, what about the traditions here at the holiday? What do you enjoy most about being here at the resort over the holidays?
The gingerbread house is probably my favorite claim to fame. We definitely get there over time, and it's nice to watch the seasons roll out. We start... I went into a ballroom the other day just to see if it was set up yet, and it was actually a storeroom for about 20 Christmas trees.
Wow.
It was the day before. They had dispersed them all around the resort. If you walk down the hallway, just about every corner, you'll find a little bit of decoration. You start coming down the drive, and they're decorating all the greeneries coming out. All these Christmas lights I didn't know we had were on our trees. You get reminded again that they're still there. Things start to change. More color comes out. It also brings a little bit of earthiness. With the farm that we have on site, they're definitely bringing some things. We have baskets where they're actually growing pumpkins and squash and zucchini.
It's great.
On our farm. So it's local, and it is that homey feel. You know, so a lot of times in the service industry, we work on the holidays, but in the service industry, we're trying to make the holiday. But at the same time, it's our family that's working.
That's
These
right.
are the people that I see just about as much as I see my family. I was just going to say, so yeah, that's kind of our celebration together.
Yeah. We appreciate the family here. And it is about family at the holidays and about giving. And we appreciate that you're going to be giving us
nice segue, Liz.
Cookies. And but it is. This is a great place to come and make memories, right?
It's so true. Yes, it's always great to be here at Terranea and to be with all of you. So thank you so much for joining us. We're going to take a bite of this. We're going to try the cookie. Thank you all so much for joining us on our holiday show. I'm Maria Sorreo for Liz Brown Swanson, and we will see you guys next time.
Okay, we'll pass this on.
Yes, we're eating some.
All right, I just had to sneak back one more time to see this amazing gingerbread chateau.
Well, thank you very much. This is probably my favorite Terranea tradition, maybe because I get to be involved in it so fully. Definitely our Terranea gingerbread chateau over here. Couple of man hours have been put into this. There's about 200 pounds of gingerbread, and I don't know if you know, we definitely put about 10 times the amount of spice in this cookie, so you can actually smell it when you walk into the room.
It's everything spice and all things nice and traditions here at Terranea, and for all of our elves back here, happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays out there.
Jingle bell, jingle bell rock, jingle bell swing and jingle bell ring, snowing and blowing, bushels of fun. Now the jingle bell hop.